Thank you for joining us for our service today. As we continue on in our sermon series, the God series, today we'll be talking about the God who speaks to us. Would you turn in your Bibles to 1 Samuel chapter 3 as we read starting from verse 1. It says this, "Meanwhile, the boy Samuel served the Lord by assisting Eli. Now in those days, messages from the Lord were very rare, and visions were quite uncommon. One night, Eli, who was almost blind by now, had gone to bed. The lamp of the Lord had not yet gone out, and Samuel was sleeping in the tabernacle near the ark of God. Suddenly, the Lord called out, 'Samuel.' 'Yes,' Samuel replied, 'what is it?' He got up and ran to Eli. 'Here am I, did you call me?' 'I didn't call you,' Eli replied. 'Go back to bed.' So he did. Then the Lord called out again, 'Samuel.' Again Samuel got up and went to Eli. 'Here I am. Did you call me?' 'I didn't call you, my son,' Eli said. 'Go back to bed.' Samuel did not yet know the Lord because he had never had a message from the Lord before. So the Lord called a third time, and once more Samuel got up and went to Eli. 'Here I am. Did you call me?' Then Eli realized it was the Lord who was calling the boy. So he said to Samuel, 'Go and lie down again. And if someone calls again, say, "Speak, Lord, your servant is listening."' So Samuel went back to bed, and the Lord came and called as before, 'Samuel, Samuel.' And Samuel replied, 'Speak, your servant is listening.' Then the Lord said to Samuel, 'I am about to do a shocking thing in Israel. I am going to carry out all my threats against Eli and his family from beginning to end. I have warned him that judgment is coming upon his family forever because his sons are blaspheming God and he hasn't disciplined them. So I have vowed that the sins of Eli and his sons will never be forgiven by sacrifices or offerings.' Samuel stayed in bed until morning. Then he got up and opened the doors of the tabernacle as usual. He was afraid to tell Eli what the Lord had said to him. But Eli called out to him, 'Samuel, my son.' 'Here am I,' Samuel replied. 'What did the Lord say to you? Tell me everything, and may God strike you and even kill you if you hide anything from me.' So Samuel told Eli everything. He didn't hold anything back. 'It is the Lord's will,' Eli replied. 'Let him do what he thinks best.' As Samuel grew up, the Lord was with him, and everything Samuel said proved to be reliable. And all Israel, from Dan in the north to Beersheba in the south, knew that Samuel was confirmed as a prophet of the Lord. The Lord continued to appear at Shiloh and gave messages to Samuel there at the tabernacle, and Samuel's words went out to all the people of Israel." Let us pray. Heavenly Father, indeed we thank you for your word. We thank you for this opportunity that we can gather together as believers, even if just online. And we pray that you would open up our eyes and our ears and our hearts and our minds to hear from you. And so God, we pray that truly your Holy Spirit would speak to us and that you would help us to be obedient to respond to you. And so we commit this message now into your hands. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Amen. In this series, the God series, we have been talking about the different characteristics of God. And one of them is the fact that God speaks to us. He is a personal and relatable God, one who speaks to his people. In this passage of scripture, we meet Samuel, a boy who is called by God. Samuel's parents were Elkanah and Hannah. We first meet them in 1 Samuel chapter 1, where we learn of the fact that Hannah was barren. She could not have children, and so she desperately wanted a child. One day she goes to the temple where she is just crying out to God, so much so that Eli the priest sees her, thinks that she's drunk, and confronts her about it. But Hannah was just so in the zone with God, crying out to him. In fact, on that day, she promised God that if he would just grant to her a son, that she would not only dedicate him to the Lord, but give him back to the Lord in service. And so God granted that prayer and answered it and gave her Samuel. Hannah was faithful to God and kept her promise. And so when the child was weaned, she dedicated Samuel to the Lord and gave him over to Eli to raise in God's service. So here we see that it was on one night when Samuel was asleep in the tabernacle that the Lord reached out and spoke to him. It's interesting when we think of the fact that God chose to speak to Samuel. Now remember that at this point, Samuel was just a boy. He was just very young. Eli, who was his mentor, who was the one guiding him and explaining the ways of the Lord to him, was a priest. And Eli had to carry out the priestly duties. So it would only make sense that Eli, who had the experience and the position, would be the one to receive messages from the Lord. But in this case, it wasn't Eli. It was Samuel. This goes to show us that the God who speaks to us speaks to everyone, no matter who we are. He is a God who speaks to each and every one of us. It doesn't matter our age, our position, whether we're educated or not, whether we go to church regularly or not. He speaks to all of us. He wants a personal relationship with each one of us. He is not just some God that stands back and watches, but he is a God who comes and gets his hands right in it and gets messy. He is a God who comes to us and wants to have that relationship with us. God speaks to us no matter who we are. Even though we may think that Eli would have been the right person for God to speak to, God was more concerned about the person, the individual's faith, than he was of their position. And so he looked upon Samuel and saw Samuel's pure heart. He saw Samuel's ability to be used by him to carry out his task. And so he spoke to Samuel. You see, we must be prepared for God to use the most unexpected people in the most unexpected places at the most unexpected times. We don't know how God is going to use us or how he's going to use another individual. And so we must be open to God speaking to us and using us. No matter who we are, we know that he speaks. God shows us over and over in his word that he is not a distant God, but he speaks to his people. He communicates with his people. He is personal. He's not just interested in speaking to pastors or evangelists or missionaries or older Christian. He is interested in speaking to every single one of us. He wants to speak to us. He wants to speak to you. We are his creation. And he loves us. So even though Samuel was a child at this point, God spoke to him directly and gave him a very important message. The problem for Samuel was that he was not used to hearing from God. In fact, he had never received a message from God, and so he didn't recognize or even realize that it was God who was speaking to him. And so he thought that it was Eli. He went to Eli, asked Eli every single time. And so there may be times in your own life where God has or is speaking to you and you don't even realize. It's important that we ask someone who is a mature Christian. It's important that if you feel the Lord might be speaking to you, talk to a spiritually mature person about it, a spiritually mature Christian about what it is that you're experiencing, what it is that you've sensed the Lord speaking to you about, for you to be able to really know that it is from the Lord. Messages from the Lord come in different ways. And it is not always crystal clear what the Lord is saying to us, or if it is the Lord saying it to us. And so it can be very confusing and it can be uncertain. And that's why it's important for us to find mature Christians that we trust and that can truly pray for us and give us godly wisdom and advice and share with us their own experience. So Samuel went to Eli and talked to Eli and found out from Eli, from speaking to Eli, that it was really God who was speaking to Samuel. You see, God spoke to Samuel in a very direct, audible way. Now, you may say, I've never heard from God. Well, God doesn't always speak to his people in a direct, audible way, the way he chose to speak to Samuel. But God certainly does speak to us, and he speaks to us in many different ways. It can be directly, it can be through visions or dreams, it can be through a message or a song, it can be through prayer, through his word, through another person speaking to you from the Lord, through books, through music. There are so many different means that God can use to speak to us. And so we must be so in tune with the Spirit to hear and to know when it is the Lord who is speaking to us. Just like how Samuel consulted Eli, it is important for us to surround ourselves with other Christian people. And I specifically say spiritually mature people. And that means that just because a person is older does not necessarily mean that they are spiritually mature. In the same way, just because a person is younger does not mean that they're not spiritually mature. Spiritually mature people come in different forms at different ages. And so it's important to surround yourself with such people. The bottom line is find yourself Christian people, someone to mentor you, to encourage you, to speak to you, to share godly insight and wisdom to you, and especially to pray for you. It's okay to ask the Lord for confirmation if you're not sure. There's nothing wrong with asking the Lord to confirm something. If you feel God is speaking to you about something, it's okay to ask him, Lord, if it's you who's speaking to me about this, please confirm it in such a way. And God is willing to do so. He understands that it might be difficult. He understands that it's not always easy to really know what he's saying, and he will confirm it. He will confirm what he's saying. But in order for us to hear from God and to really know what he's saying, we need to give the Lord the opportunity to speak to us. Give the Lord the opportunity to speak to you. Samuel, in the quiet moments of the night, gave and allowed the Lord the opportunity to speak to him. Do you allow the Lord the opportunity to speak to you? Now, before you answer, consider this. We live in an age and in a time where electronics is everything. Everything is about the latest phones or computers or gadgets. Everything is about social media or downloads or YouTube, or songs, music, movies, TV shows at the click of a button. Everything is so convenient that we're so connected to other people through electronic devices. We're either talking or texting, emailing. We're on the phone on Bluetooth, watching videos, uploading, downloading, doing all these things that we can be so consumed with what we're doing, so consumed with what's going on around us that we are not giving and allowing the Lord the opportunity to speak to us. We're not allowing God that opportunity. God is not one to yell and to scream and to shout. He is one to wait for us to give him that opportunity to talk. And when we don't give him that opportunity, it can be very difficult for us to hear what God is saying. I don't know if you've ever come across someone who just loves to talk. There are people out there like that. Maybe you're one of them. Maybe you know someone who is. But there are some people who just love to talk so much that they can literally just talk and talk and talk, and you can try to get a word in, try to say something, but it's almost like they don't let you. And so even if you try to say something, it's better that you just save your breath, because they're not going to hear you anyways. And so you just sit back and you listen, right? Or on the other hand, there are the other people where you're trying to talk to someone, but they are so busy looking at their phone, reading this, typing on their computer, texting while you're talking, or looking over this way or that way or behind you or below you, and they're just not listening to what you're saying. They're not giving you the attention that you want. And so it's almost like, okay, I'll just wait here, finish texting, you know, finish doing that, finish talking to that person, doing that. And it's almost rude for them to be doing that, but it's almost like you want to just say, I'll wait. I wonder if God ever feels like that with us, where he's trying to talk to us, where he's trying to have a conversation and communicate with us, but because we're so busy doing this, that, and everything else, that he just stands back and says, I'll wait. I'll wait until you're ready. I'll wait until you give me the opportunity. I'll wait until you allow me to speak. Are we giving God that opportunity to speak? Some people may say, I've never heard from God. I don't know what that's like. I've never experienced that. Well, maybe it's not so much that God isn't speaking. Maybe we're just not listening. Maybe we're not giving him that opportunity to quiet ourselves before him, to put away the phone, to turn off the TV, to not reply to that text message right away, and just give God that opportunity to speak to us. God has so much to say. Are you giving him the opportunity to speak? Especially in prayer. Prayer is not just us talking to God, but it's God also talking to us, for us being quiet and meditating and listening to God speak. May we allow God that opportunity. He has a lot to say. Let him say it. So Samuel allowed the Lord the opportunity to speak. May we also, like Samuel, be able to say, speak, Lord, your servant is listening. The message that God had to tell this young boy, unfortunately, was not a very pleasant one. God laid upon Samuel some very, very heavy information. He gave him this heavy message and responsibility at such a young age. And although it wasn't a very heartfelt, feel-good message, it was an important one that God had to give. You see, not all messages from God are positive and feel good, but they are important. Not all the things that God has to say to us are all going to make us feel warm and fuzzy inside. It's going to make us feel good all the time. But the things that God has to say to us may not make us feel good, but they are important. They're important to challenge us, to help us to change, to help us to move from where we are to where we need to be, to go into deeper relationship with God, to convict us to change and to be transformed. And sometimes we may have that misconception that because God is love and forgiving and mercy and peace and all of those things, that he doesn't have harsh things to say to us. But the truth of the matter is that God will only tolerate so much. And so he wants to give us that opportunity to change. And sometimes that may mean telling us some very harsh truth, things that we may not necessarily want to hear, but we need to. There are many places in the Bible where we read about how God himself, or he sent someone like a prophet to rebuke an individual or a group of people because of their actions or because of what they have been doing, so that they could repent and change their ways. The Lord may want to speak to you about many different things, whether that be your future, your job, your family, your career, money, responsibilities, things that He has in store for you. He may want to speak to you about a variety of different things, but He may also want to speak to you about some things in your life that need to be changed. And so may we be open to hearing what that is. May we be open to receiving that correction from the Lord, knowing that even though it may not necessarily be nice to hear, it is important truth that will help us to grow in deeper relationship with Him, to repent and to change, to help us realize certain things in our life and deal with it. And whether the message God has for you is one that is positive or one that's not so positive, it is important to help challenge you to change, and both are important. And so God told Samuel what was going to happen to Eli, something that was a bit heavy, but because of Eli's lack of discipline of his sons, God was going to punish him. He had warned him from before, but Eli did not heed that message and make the changes. And so God was going to carry out all that he said because of Eli's disobedience. It may have seemed a little unfair of God to lay this heavy load upon Samuel when he was just a kid. And Samuel probably was so scared to tell Eli this, thinking, who am I to give Eli, the priest, this kind of message? Is Eli going to even believe me? You know, what am I supposed to tell him? Is he going to get upset? Is he going to get angry? You know, whatever it is. And even though Samuel was afraid, he still was obedient to God and told Eli. The Bible says he told him everything and did not hold anything back. You see, when the Lord speaks, we need to be obedient to His instructions and His message. Not only do we need to hear what God is saying to us, but we need to do it. We need to put into action. We can hear God's word over and over and over again, but if we do nothing about it, what good is it? We need not only to be hearers of the word, but doers as well. May you put the word of God and what God speaks to you about in action. And may you be one who does. May you be one who helps. People are not always going to like what you may have to say, but it is important. And especially when we start to talk truth, especially when we start to make people feel uncomfortable or step on people's toes by what we have to say, it's not always going to be received well. But we have the responsibility, as Samuel did, as scared and as afraid as he was, to speak God's truth and to often may have to say some harsh reality. It's not about being concerned about other people, but it's about being obedient to God and His message to us. And sometimes we need to do the hard thing. You see, God wants us to be doers, not just hearers. And so maybe that for you is to be obedient to God by feeling led to give a financial gift to a certain family. May you not just hear from God, but may you actually do and put that into practice. Maybe God is speaking to you or leading you to just buy some extra groceries and drop it off to an individual's home. May you not just hear or feel, but may you also do. Maybe God's speaking to you about starting to tithe regularly or give over and above your regular tithes. May you not just hear, but may you also start to do. Whatever it is that God may be leading you to do or speaking to you about, may you truly carry out God's message and instructions. You see, in order for us to receive God's message, we need not only to hear, but to be willing to act upon what He tells us to do. Our God is not just some distant figure who stands back and listens and watches, but He is one who speaks to His creation. God loves us and he desires to communicate with us. He desires to have regular communication on a regular basis. May we be so in tune with God's Spirit that we not only hear his voice, but we recognize when he is speaking to us. The God who speaks to us speaks to everyone, no matter who we are. If you feel the Lord might be speaking to you, speak to a spiritually mature person about it. Give the Lord the opportunity to speak to you. Remember that not all messages from God are positive and feel good, but they are important. And when the Lord speaks, we need to be obedient to his message and his instructions. Let us pray. Heavenly Father, indeed we thank you for this time. We thank you, Lord, for the truths that we learn from this passage of Scripture and from Samuel and Eli. And Lord, we desire for you truly to speak to us in different ways. We thank you that the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords, the Creator and the Sustainer of the universe, desires to speak to us. And so, God, may you help us to truly listen and to recognize your voice. May you help us, Lord, to know when it is that you are speaking and what it is that you are saying. And we pray that, God, in the midst of all that is going on in the busyness of life and in all of the things that we do day by day, may you also help us to remember to give you the opportunity to speak. And so, Lord, help us not only to hear or to read your word, but to do what you've called us to do. And so, God, we thank you. I pray for each one who is listening that your blessings would rest upon them, upon their family, and that you would continue to help us day by day. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Amen.